Glasgowbury made the music scene sort of bang. Do you know what I mean? Like, it was like the big bang. It was like, there was so much potential, but Glasgowbury seen that potential and it made it happen.
The world suddenly became a smaller place and you could be, you know, celebrating your music in, you know, on a mountain in Draperstown, and if you weren't just, you know, some wannabes, you know, trying to, like, you know, play in front of the mirror with a tennis racket. This is real people, real music, you know, and this is something that obviously has been proven is, you know, huge, like massive, yeah.
I'll be honest, last year's Glasgowbury was my first sober one, and I seen more of that than all the other festivals combined. But what I seen was crowds going from stage to stage, just taking in everything, which would never have happened before.
Bands just came from everywhere, sprouted up from everywhere. Do you know what I mean? And it just became mental.
It's like, it can be this good in Northern Ireland, you know? It can be this good, you know? It doesn't need to be, you don't need to piss off somewhere to do these things or whatever. Like, there's a homegrown support here for music. Like, and everybody's into it and buzzing off it. And then all the, like, the things that come, like the G sessions and everything as well. I think the last G session I've ever done has always been one of the craziest gigs of my life.
All of a sudden, there was this incredible wave of bands, you know, and everybody was great. Everybody was really good. Everyone had merit. There was nobody, you know, it was really exciting.
If you were to say somebody, I'm going to design a festival and it's going to have, you know, upwards of 5,000 people going out every day, and you were to say, right, this is what I want to do. I want to stick it on a mountain top, you know, the side of a mountain, and I want there to be 6 stages, and I want there to be, you know, this and that, and I want it to be, you know, 70 miles outside of Belfast. You would get laughed out of the shop.
We're a quite, I suppose, unique organisation in a way that we were the first to do it. We learned to do it, how to do it, why to do it. We learned how to, the whole ethos is built on a platform for new bands, new music, get out there. But also at the same time, it was a platform for people to develop.
I think Glasgowbury's led the way when it comes to local festivals. You know, there's a big festival culture at the minute, and it's great to see. There's lots of other festivals, but Glasgowbury was there
is, you know, first.
It's something to aim for. It's whenever we were, I was very young, there was never an end in sight, somewhere that you could actually go and play at a festival that represented everything that was good about music and from where you were from.
Small But Massive has had a massive impact. What is it, 11, 12 years old this year. And it's there's been a drive in the music industry locally over the last, we've seen a change over the last 10 years, I should say, and Glasgowbury has been very much part of that.
Having the value of having that type of outlet for our local musicians, our local music industry, or the people who are actually producing it, putting the actual gig on, running it, is just invaluable. You can't put a price on it, and I don't think anybody is aware of what the real intrinsic value of it is.
At Glasgowbury, straight away you hear the history, you know, when you know that it started kind of in a backyard, basically, you know, and became this festival in quite a short time as well. And I think that rebellious streak and real, like, you know, link to the musician, because I think there's a real clear link to the musician with Glasgowbury, where all our bodies within Northern Ireland seem that the link's stronger to, you know, maybe the admin, businessy side of things. And I think, you know, Glasgowbury's the kind of guy that comes dressed as a techie, you know, the combats and the lanyards and all on, like, where maybe the other ones you'd expect them to arrive in some nice shiny shoes.
Glasgowbury has sort of grown over time, and what it's done now for music and culture generally in Northern Ireland as a whole, arguably even in the UK, it's set up a new way of existing, way of being and way of operating that has changed I think it's changed the face of music. I mean, what it's always been trying to do is just promote new music and new bands and new artists and people starting out.
I mean, it's almost it's a very Northern Irish attitude, I think, that, you know, comes even from, you know, back in the day when Stiff Little Fingers were, you know, still playing the Ulster Hall as the rest of the city was shut down. You know, it's very stubborn and passionate. And
I think Northern Ireland has become very, very fruitful of late. And I think, you know, even I watched the Good Vibrations movie there the other day, and it was just amazing to see, like, how there was, you know, everybody always has that kind of musical and artistic tension bubbling up underneath the surface whenever stuff like really problematic situations are happening. And I can see, I didn't experience the troubles, but since I have been growing up, I've noticed how, you know, there wasn't really like a music scene or a music culture. And now, because there's so many people behind it and people believing in music and how it can really brighten people's lives up, and, you know, I don't know, it is a valued job, and, like, it's amazing that Glasgowbury has contributed in the way that they have, because they're encouraging younger people and younger generations to grow up then to be the older generations to really appreciate what music and culture is all about.
I think it attempts to do a kind of a temperature gauge every year of where things are at. And I've always admired that, and I've always felt that that's the way even a programme should be, you know, each week. What's the temperature gauge this week? What's floating around, you know? What should we try and unearth?
I was living in London when Glasgowbury started, so I've been able to traffic its progress from the outside. And then I moved back to Northern Ireland 5 years ago and actually attended the first one in 2007 for me. And I was blown away by coming onto the site and seeing something that is the equivalent of a mainland European rock festival, something you'd see in Poland or Hungary or Germany, in that level of organisation. And whenever bands see something so well organised, so well drilled, sounding so good, the production value being so high, it inspires them to better themselves, to improve their stage. And what you get then is a positive cycle of improvement. And that's what Northern Ireland always lacked in the DIY underground scene.
Glasgowbury has shown the bands in Northern Ireland how a festival should be run, how a gig should be run, in terms of the application process. You have to have your stuff together, you have to have your press pack ready, you need people to be able to access your tunes to then being accepted. to then working out a way to get there as well, because it's obviously in the middle of nowhere. And when you get there, there's all the things that bigger bands take for granted in terms of backstage and your passes and your access and your tickets for your beverages and your food. You're always very well taken care of. So it's kind of showing that that's the way it should be, rather than stick your gear there, son, and get off stage. You know, you're well looked after.
Point to people who have been given confidence from it, you know, to give it a go, to give whatever it is a go, whether it be photography or a sound man or a crew or a journalist, whatever it is, or a musician, obviously, is that not to always aim small, that you can't aim big, you can go bigger. It doesn't mean you have to lose certain core values, but you can definitely give everything a go. I think from kind of seeing the inner workings of Glasgow a few times, when there's been things that potentially could have gone wrong, but they pulled through at the last minute and solved it, is the kind of ethos that certainly comes to mind for me a lot of times on tour. When something looks like it's going to go wrong, there has been literally a couple of times when I thought, what would Glasgow do, you know, to kind of solve the situation. There's always a way around it. So it's just, I think for me, Glasgow is just about giving people confidence and making sure that you aim high, but you can still remember where you came from and your roots.
Its name now speaks for itself, do you know what I mean? And I know everyone involved has worked damn hard to put it where it is, and it's totally paid off. It's not just people in this country know about it too. We regularly have people flying in from England who are fans of our band who go, what's happening over there? Because there's nothing like it in England even, you know what I mean? There's a lot of boutique shite.
And it came out of nowhere as well. That's the best thing about it, you know what I mean? It wasn't orchestrated in Belfast by the pulsating brains of the music industry, you know, supposedly. It came from, you know, Draperstown. It came from rural, you know, it was the people. And that's what was so important about it, you know, it was amazing.
When I started the festival, as you know, there was no policy for music. It was like, what? Contemporary music?
It's all about the music. It's all about supporting and giving access to people and knocking down doors. I know what Paddy Glasgow's like because he's knocked on my door so many times, and he's not a guy that you can say no. You might think you're going to say no to Paddy, but you'll end up giving him what he wants and a biscuit because he's that type of guy. And he's a wonderful guy to have. But the legacy of Glasgowbury is, you can't underestimate it, you just can't. It's been one of the best rallying points. You know, and bands like And So I Watch You From Afar, General Fiasco, Fighting My Wire will tell you that. You know, it's the place where everything gets galvanised, plans are formed, bands are formed up that hill, you know. A lot of stuff goes on up that hill.
Yeah. I don't know. I would like to believe that it's going to be something people of my generation and people of the next generations will just always remember. I hope it's still going, you know what I mean, in 20, 30 years' time. But even if it isn't, you know, we're all going to be sitting, looking back, going, Jesus, do you remember the time, you know what I mean?
I think that any project that starts with no money and builds up a level of self-sustainability as an inspiration to anyone who works in the commercial arts sphere. So that's its legacy. It's not so much the fact that 5,000, 6,000 people, you know, sell the site out each year, and that hundreds of bands have passed through there. It's a much deeper and a much broader thing, in that it proves that if an idea is good and the notion is pure and everyone that works on a project has noble intent, then it can't help but be successful. That's what it proves, and that's the inspiration and the legacy of Glasgowbury.
Its legacy is, it's everything about it. It's the fact that they work with everybody in terms of there's no agenda beyond putting on a great festival, to be training up a great bunch of people to run the festival, to run events during the year. Mm-hmm. It's about building an industry, and that's important no matter what your industry is, and this is a creative industry, and for it to sustain itself, we need to have professionals in terms of engineers, in terms of camera crews, in terms of people who know not to touch that button, and but know how to get that amp and make sure that nobody blows up, that know how to run a guest list, that know how to run media passes. It's that level of industry. Although we all go and have a great weekend, all those things need done, but it's that takes all year to pull all that together, to get those people trained, that they are then more employable in those particular fields. That before Glasgowbury, I don't believe there was the opportunity for that on such a scale.
Glasgowbury's legacy. Oh, well, there's a lot of legacies. Like, you know, I mean, in terms of a festival, it's just it's created an amazing community and vibe. It's given confidence to local music, to bands, to young bands, emerging bands. They feel like they can get onto the festival circuit because of Glasgowbury. Glasgowbury has kind of Glasgowbury is now an incredibly professional festival. It only features local music. It puts our local bands on as headliners. And I guess that's a great sort of vote of confidence for Northern Irish music, that, you know, you can draw 5,000 people to see the likes of And So I Watch From Far, John Fiasco, you know, Fight With Wire, Cashew Number 9, whoever, without having to do the big draw because a well-known outside band is playing, or, you know, it's been heavily promoted by a huge, massive promoter. It's managed to give local music a platform. I think that's the main legacy.
I think it's one of those things that everybody smiles when they talk about it. I think that's its biggest legacy. Like the feeling it gives everybody. Everyone's like, it's G-Session. It's the weekend, it's Glasgowbury weekend, you know. Just everybody is pumped for it. And nobody can say a bad word about it, because there isn't a bad word to be said about it.
Basically, in the last, say, 3 or 4 years, you know, where Glasgowbury got really, really big. It's became kind of like a centre point, especially for musicians around the North Coast. You know, I couldn't talk for Belfast because I wouldn't be as involved in that, but around here it's more like it's a centre thing. You know, it's in the middle of the year, it's the biggest event, you know, every band you know plays there, and it's like, for a lot of young bands, it's giving them somewhere to aim for, where before, if you're in a young band and you're writing away at demos, the only thing you could think of is maybe, oh, need to get to England, need to get a record deal, need to get out of here, need the money to come in, where now you've got recognisable steps. You know, you go, right, get on local radio, get a couple of gigs. If you get a couple of gigs, maybe G-Sessions might take us on. Get a G-Sessions, might get on the Glasgowbury. Get on the Glasgowbury. Then you've got, you know, Radio All-Star get involved, and then you can see a clear path now of how to get your band from just playing, you know, fucking the weekend Strabane, to actually maybe getting a wee tour, or, you know, getting someone to recognise you in England through your hard work, rather than just handing on a demo. You know, setting out 50 of them and phoning everybody every weekend, you know, have you listened to that, have you listened to that? And, you know, where you can actually focus on the creative side, and you can focus on the work side and your live show, because you know that's going to pay off a wee bit more, because it's kind of like, how do I say it, like the real way it should have been.
I think, be its legacy, I think, you know, its legacy will be, you know, it's the People's Festival. You know, I think, you know, it will be a beacon. It'll be something people can, you know, will always name check, will always, especially if you're from Northern Ireland and you understand where it came from. You know, I feel that people will always return to that sort of that initial plan, you know, what Glasgowbury was and how it grew. And because of the, I've said it before, the honesty and stuff, you know, and the passion for music and bands. It doesn't matter about status. It doesn't matter about, there's no tags. Everyone's equal. And it's like, it's just fantastic. It's so enjoyable. It's, you know, if you've never been to the festival, go and witness it for yourself, because it's quite special. So I think, it's the ultimate DIY festival, you know, for the people. So
I think it's great legacy. There's going to be a number of different legacies, I think, from Glasgowbury. One of which is going to be that temperature gauge that I talked about, that notion of an annual kind of reading of where Northern Irish music's at. There are a lot of festivals out there, and they're wonderful, don't get me wrong. Lots of festivals have come up in recent years, but none have that same authoritative reputation that Glasgowbury has. I think it's also its attitude is going to be very important. There'll be a definite legacy there, and it's definitely part of the Northern Irish experience, that attitude. You see it in kind of, you know, the undertones. You see it in Terry Hooley. You see this kind of sense of, you know, we're going to just do it anyway, even though it's impossible, even though the odds are against us, we're going to do it. And Glasgowbury's leaving that legacy. But I think that the legacy that Glasgowbury wants to leave, I think it will leave eventually, and that is to have a kind of a sense of Mid Ulster being reflected in music from here, because sometimes it can be a bit polarized, and I accept that. You know, it can be sometimes Belfast centric at times, sometimes it can be Derry centric. Mm-hmm. And of course, that's not the reality of what music from here is like. It's all over the place. There's this wonderful, rich seam of music.
I think Glasgowbury and the sort of small but massive ethos as a whole, yeah, its legacy, I think we'll feel the, you know, the, as that ripples out, I think you'll, you know, feel that forever, you know.
The legacy of Glasgowbury. The Glasgowbury has been on the go for now for about 12 years, and the number of other different music festivals that are popping up around the north, sort of following in that type of blueprint, is and being generated by musicians on the ground, and is phenomenal. And the people who are actually running Glasgowbury are running that many other different things in the background now in Northern Ireland. It's unbelievable. Like, even like Waikiki doing the production stuff, they're obviously in the middle of all the city culture stuff. They're running loads of stuff in Belfast. And a lot of the people here coming through courses, like what we had run here at the Nerve Centre, a lot of our people ended up working at Glasgowbury because of the connections we have here with the actual festival. But it's generating, it's actually building the industry and helping to foster the industry. It's a byproduct of running a really good festival, is that everybody gets educated in how to work up a festival, how to promote a festival, how to produce a festival. And then all these people are like, well, that's happening once a year, but I can go away and do other stuff. And then your industry starts to build from that. So it's like going out and sowing a field. And then the field just going mad.
I think Glasgowbury, everybody knows Glasgowbury for the festival, and it'll always be remembered for the festival. If the festival attracts 5,000 people, 10,000 people, or 50 people,
yeah,
it'll still be remembered for what it is. The stuff that Glasgowbury does on the ground and everywhere else, it's things like that that I think will have the biggest legacy, because somebody coming in to get tutored to play guitar, or somebody coming in to learn drums, or somebody coming to dance, or somebody coming in to find out how they can write an application to go and start a new creative job. It's those people that will filter out into the world and go and get jobs, and they'll go and start bands, and they'll go and do work. And those are the people that will carry a bit of Glasgowbury with them. And if Glasgowbury can help in some way to, I mean, very simply, just help people write a lyric of a song, or help them press record on a camera and get them inspired and get them interested in something in the creative industries at all, then that to me is legacy, and that's what it's all about.
Unless government, and hopefully I can get that message across, can look at that right, rather than just going, there's that pot there for I think what you do, it's not going to work, because I don't want to be part of something that might just do. I want to be part of something that keeps that heartbeat pumping into the one area, the one arena. I mean, every year we start, we don't have a massive budget, we don't really have anything, we just start from scratch. I mean, some would say it's high risk. Maybe it is, but all we can do for on behalf of the legacy is try and keep it going.
I wake up every day with an anvil on my head. Sometimes I wish I was dead. Think of why I awaken, who I wanna be. I prefer- fair the way I am to the icy people I meet. Gonna shave off my pile and keep my head held high. Take the gale on my chin. And though my needs are many and my pockets like a hole, when I clasp a glimpse of your smiling eyes, I feel the flames in my soul. Work's drying up and the painted smiles are gone. Lost haze of the summer sun. And no matter where I go or what I read, I'll never know my years of living life and what have I to show. Money makes the globe spin, stays the daily pain. Keeps me out of the rain. When I wanna lay my head, I scream and I curse, trying to exorcise the demons who've conquered this summit first. I wanna find out who I am, take my head from the sand. Can you understand? That's inside would purge the rising tide, but the serenity you